can't forget. You go down home when the sun goes low. Head off the highway to a painted western sky. Walk down a worn path through the back door. Cooking in the kitchen and the kettle is warm. Then you sit down.
Welcome to Great Chefs of the West, a video symposium of regional cookery offered by chefs from the West and Southwest. From Los Angeles, an appetizer by chefs Mary Sue Milliken and Susan Feniger. From Houston, Texas, an entree by chef Robert Del Grande. From Tucson, Arizona, dessert by chef Donna Norton. And home-based cooking from the State Fair of Texas.
It's been said, perhaps cynically, that the restaurant business is founded on the rock-solid principles of nepotism and sexual harassment. Susan Feniger, foreground, and Mary Sue Milliken can't argue with at least half of that statement. After graduation from Chicago's Washburn Chef School, Mary Sue pestered her way into the kitchen at Le Perroquet in Chicago, and Susan was the only woman in her class at the Culinary Institute of America in Hyde Park. Those days are over. Their two Los Angeles restaurants are the toast of the town, and one of them, Border Grill, is a showplace for great Mexican food, like their version of the ubiquitous guacamole.
So we're going to demonstrate guacamole, and it's a pretty classic dish there. One of the things that we learned when we were in Mexico was to actually not add the tomatoes into the guacamole itself, which is a change that I think we'd always done before, but it was a way that we realized it used to water down the actual dish itself.
And if you cut it into quarters, you can peel it back like this and have a minimal waste. We find that's the fastest and easiest way to get the avocado peeled.
This way,
along with avocado, finely diced red onion.
Find that eventually you'll be much faster.
Chopped cilantro.
Chopped
finely diced jalapeno.
And then we're going to mash these. Use my hand.
Do we have mashers?
Yeah. Oh. We're going to mash these avocados with the onions and chilies. We don't mash them too much. We like it to be a little bit chunky and... We're going to need a little bit of salt.
Maybe a mostarda, yeah.
And the cilantro. And some fresh lime juice.
And the way that you get, the best way to get juice out is to put a fork in and then turn the fork and squeeze at the same time. And once you're experienced, you can not worry about the seeds and you can pick them out later. Or you can do it in a separate bowl and then strain it. So it depends how much juice is in the limes to know how much you want to add into it. And as the chilies sit in the mixture, it becomes spicier as it sits. So you want to wait, let it sit to adjust.
Mm-hmm.
Tiny bit of white pepper. Tastes good to me.
So we use a little bit of shredded lettuce when we serve it, and a slice of tomato.
And what we found is that by adding the tomato on the side, you could still have the taste of tomatoes and also not water down your guacamole.
There's a road headed to the west. Call me back again. There's a pale blue sky and a north sunset and a place I can't forget. You go down home when the sun goes low. western sky. Walk down a worn path through the back door. Cooking in the kitchen and the kettle is warm. Then you sit down.